Hello viewers, welcome to the UN College digital class. I am Pratichi Das, lecturer in MCom Finance and Control. So in today's lecture, we will discuss about a new topic, that is balance of payment. What is balance of payment? The topic contains two words. One is balance, another one is payment. So balancing all the payments or all the transactions of a country and making them in a particular systematic record or keeping them in a particular systematic record, that is known as our balance of payment. So let's start about the topic, that is balance of payment. So before going to the topic, we will discuss about some items which are used in balance of payment. So a country has to deal with other countries. When one country deals with other countries or a domestic country deals with the foreign countries, it deals with different items, or in the balance of payment, different items are recorded or different transactions are recorded. So those transactions include visible items, invisible items, capital transfers. So what are visible items? The visible items are the items which are physically existent or which are touchable and which we seen, the goods or services or the goods which we can touch, which are physically existed, those are known as our visible items. Those items or those goods are imported and exported by a country to the other countries. Another item is invisible item. The invisible items are not seen, not touched. Those are only realized by the person. Those are comes under different types of services. Another item is capital transfers, which are concerned with capital receipts and capital payment of a country. So, according to Kindleberger, the balance of payment of a country is a systematic record of all economic transactions between the residents of the reporting country and the residents of foreign countries during a given period of time. It is a double entry system of record of all economic transactions between the residents of a country and the rest of the world, carried out in a specific period of time. When we say a country's balance of payments, we are referring to the transactions of its citizens and government. So, according to Kindleberger, the balance of payment of a country is a systematic record of all economic transactions. So, balance of payment is what? It is a systematic record of all economic transactions. So, what are the economic transactions? The economic transactions are the transactions of a country which are deals between the residents of a domestic country with the rest of the world. All the transactions of a country, of the residents of that particular country with all the foreign countries or with the rest of the world comes under the economic transaction. So balance of payment is a systematic record of all economic transactions of a country, and it is a double entry system of transactions. So it is a double entry system of record of all economic transactions between the residents of a country and the rest of the world. According to Reserve Bank of India, the balance of payment of a country is a systematic record of all economic transactions between the residents of a country and the rest of the world, which represents classified record of all receipts and accounts of goods exported, services rendered and capital received by residents and payments made by them on account of goods imported and services received from the capital transfer to the non-residents or foreigners. So, according to the Reserve Bank of India, balance of payment is a systematic record of all economic transactions and the transactions of all goods and services which are imported by the residents of India and the payments made by the residents of the India to the foreign countries or the foreign residents are recorded in a systematic transaction or systematic process. That record is known as our balance of payment. So the features of balance of payments are, it is a systematic record of all economic transactions between one country and the rest of the world. So we have already discussed about that the balance of payment is a process, or it is a record, or it is a statement which records all economic transactions of a country in a systematic process with the rest of the world. So first feature of balance of payment is, it is a systematic record of all economic transactions between one country and the rest of the world. It includes all transactions that are visible as well as invisible. So balance of payment records, or balance of payment is a systematic record of all transactions which are includes visible items as well as invisible items. So what are the visible items? The visible items are the items which are touched, which are seen, and that are physically exist. But invisible items are not physically existed. So balance of payment includes or transacted or recorded all the visible items and invisible items. So next feature of balance of payment is, it relates to a period of time. So balance of payment relates to a period of time. That means balance of payment is maintained for a particular period of time. That may be quarter, on a quarter basis, or on a year basis. So it has a particular period of time, and generally it is an annual statement. So generally balance of payment is represented as an annual statement. It adopts a double entry bookkeeping system. Balance of payment adopts a double entry bookkeeping system. So what is double entry bookkeeping system? In accounting, we have already read about the double entry bookkeeping system. That means every entry has a corresponding another entry in another transaction. That means every debit transaction has a corresponding credit transaction. That is known as our double entry system or double entry transaction. So in balance of payment, every economic transaction or every debit economic transaction has a corresponding credit transaction in the statement. So it adopts the double entry system. It has two sides. One is credit side and another one is the debit side. So balance of payment has two sides, like accounting statement. It is a statement, it has also two sides. One is credit side, another one is the debit side. In debit side, we recorded all the payments, and in credit side, we record all the receipts of the economic transactions of a country. So the next feature of balance of payment is, receipts are recorded on the credit side and payments on the debit side. So next we will discuss about the balance of trade. So what is balance of trade? Before going to the balance of trade, we get a knowledge about two things. One is import, another one is the export. So what is import? When a domestic country purchases or deals the transaction or imported or purchases the goods from the foreign country, or purchases the goods across the boundary of its domestic nation, that transactions are known as our import of goods. So what is export of goods? When a domestic country sells or transfers the goods and services across the boundary of the foreign countries, or sells the goods to the foreign countries, the transactions made with the foreign countries for selling the goods and services, that is known as our exports of goods. So in balance of trade, two things are important. One is import of goods, another one is the export of goods. So difference between a country's imports and its export is known as our balance of trade. So what is balance of trade? When a country imports the goods and services and exports the goods and services, the difference between the import of a country and the difference between the export of a country is known as our balance of trade. So what is trade? Trade means the exchanging of goods and services. So balancing of trade means when import of the country are equal to, or maintaining all the imports of the goods and maintaining all the exports of the goods and make them balance. So when the difference, or when we create a difference between the imports of a country and exports of a country, and that is known as our balance of trade. So balance of trade is the largest component of a country's balance of payment. Balance of trade is a component in the statement of balance of payment, and it is a large component in the balance of payment. The debit item includes imports, foreign aids, domestic spending abroad, and domestic investments abroad. So it has also two sides, like balance of payment. So balance of trade has two sides. One is debit side, another one is the credit side. All the imports or all the payments of the balance of payment or balance of trade are recorded in the debit side, and all the receipts or exports, when we are doing the export transaction, we are receiving from the foreign countries. When we are doing import transaction, we are paying to the foreign countries. So in the import item, in the balance of trade, the debit items are all the import transactions, the foreign aid, the domestic spending abroad. That means all the domestic investment which are done with the abroad, and the domestic investments are abroad, that are comes under the debit side of balance of trade. And in the credit side of balance of trade arises all the exports, foreign spending in the domestic economy, and foreign investment in the domestic economy. Through the process of foreign spending and foreign investment in the domestic economy, all the foreign currencies or all the receipts or foreign investments or foreign cash flows, that means cash inflows or capital inflows, are comes into the country, that are the receipts for a country, that for these are shows in the credit side of balance of trade. So in balance of trade, when exports are greater than imports, then the balance of trade is favorable, and if imports are greater than exports, then it is unfavorable. So as we know, the balance of trade is the difference between the import and export of a country. So when we make a differences between import and export, that statement or that record is known as our balance of trade. It is a important component, it is a large component of balance of payment. So the balance of trade is favorable or unfavorable. When the credit items are more than the debit items of a balance of trade, that is known as our favorable balance of trade. When the import items are more than the export items, or the debit item is more than the credit item, that is known as our unfavorable balance of trade. So here we will discuss about the balance of trade versus the balance of payment. So there are difference between the balance of trade and balance of payment. The balance of payment takes into account all the transactions with the rest of the world, where the balance of trade takes into account all the trade transactions with the rest of the world. So in the first differences between the balance of trade and the balance of payment, the first item is the balance of payment takes all the transactions, that means all the economy transactions of a country, that means all transactions are included in the balance of payment one country doing with the rest of the world. But in balance of trade, the transactions, the only trade transactions are recorded. What are the trade transactions? Only import and export of goods, or import and export transactions, are recorded in the balance of trade. So that for the balance of payment contains all the economic transactions of a country, and the balance of trade contains only the trade transactions of the country. So next difference between the balance of trade and balance of payment are the formula. How we calculate the balance of trade? The net earning on export minus the net payment for imports. So for the export, we are for the purpose of export, we are earning, and for the purpose of imports, we are paying. That means a country earns when it exports the goods to the other country, and a country pays when the country import goods from the other country. So balance of trade is the differences between the net exports or the net receipts in the exports and the net payments in the imports. So the formula for calculating the balance of trade is net earning on export minus net payment for imports. The formula for calculating the balance of payment is the balance of trade plus net earning on foreign investment minus payment made to foreign investors plus cash transfer plus cash plus capital account plus or minus all the balancing items. Or another formula is the current account plus capital account or plus or minus of balancing items. The balancing items includes the errors and omissions. So for calculating the balance of payment, we consider two accounts, that are capital account, another one is the current account. The combination of all transactions of current account and capital account and balancing the items on errors and omission, we should produce or we should calculate the balance of payment. So as we are discussing about the differences between balance of trade and balance of payment, or balance of trade versus balance of payment, there are different bases. The bases are called as nature of transactions, capital transactions, mutual relation, favorable balance of trade and balance of payment. According to the nature of transactions, the transactions concerning trade of goods only are recorded. As we know, in the balance of trade, only the trade of goods or only the trade transactions are recorded in the balance of trade. So according to the nature of basis, balance of trade records all the trade transactions, where the balance of payment records all the economic transactions of a country. So all the economic transactions of a country with the rest of the world are recorded in the balance of payment. So another basis is capital transaction. The transactions of capital nature are not included in balance of trade, but in balance of payment, transactions of capital nature are also recorded in the balance of payment. So the nature of capital or capital, what are the capital transaction? The capital transactions are in the nature of a long term transaction, or the transactions which maturity period is more than 1 year, that are comes under the capital nature transaction, or transactions which are under the capital nature. So balance of trade does not recorded the transactions which are in the nature of capital or which are in capital nature, but balance of payment records all the transactions which are in or which are comes under the capital nature. That means the transaction for a medium term process or for a long term process. According to the mutual relation, balance of trade is a part of current account of balance of payment. But in balance of payment, it is much larger, as it has current and capital account which include balance of payment too. So according to the mutual relation, balance of trade is a part of balance of payment. Balance of trade is one content, or balance of trade is a part or important content of the balance of payment. But in balance of payment, it contains both accounts, as called as current account and capital account. So next basis is favorable balance of trade and balance of payment. When exports of goods are higher than the imports of goods, balance of trade is considered as favorable. When net balance of current account and capital account is in plus or is in a favorable position, balance of payment is considered as favorable. So as we know, the balance of trade records only the trade transaction or only the export and import transactions of a country. So it records only import transactions and export transactions, that are known as our trade transaction. When the export transaction is more than the import transaction, then we consider balance of trade is favorable. But in balance of payment, as it contains all the economic transaction of a country with the rest of the world, it contains the capital account and current account. So when the capital account and current accounts balance is in a favorable process or is in a plus process, that is known as our favorable balance of payment. So otherwise we called as it is a surplus balance of payment or deficient balance of payment. So when all the receipts transactions of a balance of payment are more than, or the credit side of a balance of payment is more than the debit side of balance of payment, or more than the debit side, it is known as our favorable balance of payment or surplus balance of payment. Thank you.